Take two. Hello, everybody, and welcome to The Walking Dead Season 1. Now, I played this before, but that was quite a while back, and every playthrough is different because I'm not going to choose the exact same things I chose the last time. It will be impossible for me to. So I'm going to play it again, and this time I'm going to actually record it. And hopefully not hiccup again. Holy shit. I'm going to record it since the last time I played it. It was before I even got my Xbox One. It was, hold on, November. Yeah, I was borrowing an Xbox One. Now, this is take two because I did try recording, but forgot to enable my microphone. Delete that and restart it. Because, yeah, whoops. So, I've watched season one, I've watched season two, 400 days, and whatever's out of season three right now. But every playthrough is different. I definitely would choose quite a bit differently from quite a few of the things that Jacksepticeye, who's the person I've been watching, play it. I'm definitely going to choose, well, I didn't watch him play season one. I watched someone else play season one because he didn't do season one. But I definitely choose a lot of the different things. Different from him. But let's start a new game in season one. And let's see how it goes. A new day. And and this time I actually have my mic on. So that's good. The Walking Dead. Jeez, the difference in graphics from season 3 to back to season 1. Holy shit. That's insane.
Well, I reckon you didn't do it then.
Why do you say that?
You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
And what do you say?
I say, yep, I know you didn't. Followed your case a little bit, you being a Macon boy and all.
What do you think?
I'm just glad I chose law and not order. Big messy trial like that. Even if you was innocent, a lot of what happened can't ever be undone. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Sure.
Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just waved.
Something's going on.
Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting. And before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property, and I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
So did he do it?
They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Watch out!
This other time we...
Well, didn't listen to my warning.
Officer, are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here.
Why the hell did he have his gun out? I need to drag myself out that window.
Come on. Ow. Jeez, that was a fall. Alright, come on, Lee. Shit. I'm gonna pick up the alright.
Looks empty. It'll be easier to carry with these cuffs off.
Yeah.
Officer?
Officer? I have a bad feeling about this. He's gonna jump at me. Oh my.
Officer?
Holy shit! What in the hell? Get away from me!
Grab the shotgun first. And, the bullet.
The hell are you? Shit.
Oh my god, you idiot.
Don't make me do this!
Man.
Hey! Go get someone! There's been a shooting!
You idiot. You just tripped over what's left of his cranium. Come on. Made it over the fence.
Hello? Anybody?
You got up to the last door. Anyone inside?
Hello? Anybody home? I need a little help.
Coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Ah, shit. Hello? I'm not an intruder. Or one of them.
These people might need more help than I do.
Well, the fruit.
It's fake. Damn.
It's fake.
Oh, Jesus.
3 new messages. Message 1 left at 5:43 p.m.
Hey, Sandra. This is Diana. We're still in Savannah. Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2, left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my god, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3, left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you. We love you. We love you.
Who is this?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee.
You're not my daddy.
No, I'm not. are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Where are you?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window.
Hey, X. Of course. Oh God, that. Damn. I think I went a little too overboard, but
man. Hi there.
Did you kill it?
Yes.
It's okay. I think she was a monster.
I think so too. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah. I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
Alright, so
oh man,
I ain't never getting home to mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Well, let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea. Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us! We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
We need help.
Are you trying to get out of here? Because you should be. Those things are all over the damn place. I haven't seen anything as gnarly as this neighborhood since downtown Atlanta, 15 miles back. I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. I'm just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
I...
Them monsters coming.
We gotta go.
Lee, quick, let's go.
One, push, push, push. Yeah, come on, Clementine. Give us the extra little help we needed. There we go. Just hops in the back.
For just some guy, it seems like you saved a bunch of lives today.
No, I try to be nice. Save some people.
Hey, Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both.
I don't think we ever see him, do we?
Thank God you're okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days. Old Brecken down the way thinks his mare's gone lame, but that ain't nothing new.
I wouldn't have made it back without Chet.
Well, I'm glad you took him with you, then. You've brought a couple guests.
Your boy's a lifesaver.
Glad he could be a help to somebody. So it's just you and your daughter, then?
Oh, not his daughter. He's, well, just some guy who found her alone.
Honey, do you know this man?
Yes.
Okay, then. Well, looks like you hurt your leg pretty bad there.
Yeah, it's not doing so good.
I can help you out. Sean, run on in and check on your sister. You, take a seat up on the porch and I'll go see what I have. Let's have a look. Yeah. This is swollen to hell.
Could be worse.
That's what it sounds like. Seems like things got awful bad in the cities. What did you say your name was?
It's Lee.
Nice to meet you, Lee. I'm Herschel Green.
Yeah, I'm not gonna...
How'd this happen?
I fell, trying to get away from one of those things.
That's so. What type of danger has the girl seen?
Who knows? She had a few lonely days with nothing but the dead keeping her company.
I still just can't imagine it.
Consider yourself lucky.
House is full up with mine. We got another displaced family of three sleeping in the barn. You and your daughter are welcome to rest there when we're done here. I didn't catch your name, darling.
Clementine.
Can't imagine what you've been through, Clementine.
Looking after her until we find her parents.
Hey, Dad, so I'm thinking, first thing tomorrow, we gotta reinforce the fence around the farm.
That doesn't seem necessary.
I don't know what you saw on TV or heard on the radio, but there's some serious shit hitting the fan. I don't think anyone knows how big it is yet.
Your son's right. You're gonna want to fortify this place.
Stuff like that doesn't happen around here, Sean.
Dad, I'm serious. Lee, come on. Tell him what you saw out there, man.
I got chased by a couple of dead people.
Well, do what you think you should. We got plenty of chores as it is.
Lee and those folks in the barn can help out in the morning. We gotta do it. Really.
I already said okay. Well, I'm all done here. It should start to feel better tomorrow.
Thanks.
If your leg gets hot or the swelling doesn't go down, you're probably dealing with an infection.
What do we do then?
We'll probably just have to shoot you. We'll clean it, redress it, and you'll be fine.
Okay, that'd be preferable.
There's blankets and such in the barn. We'll be seeing you bright and early. Come tomorrow, which way you think you're headed?
Towards Macon, I suppose. All right, then.
It smells like...
manure.
Manure? Like when a horse plops?
Just like that.
I missed my mom and dad.
I bet, Clem.
How far is Savannah?
Pretty far.
Oh, okay. I love you,
baby. Hey, get up.
I'm itchy.
Well, you slept in a barn, little lady. Lucky you don't have spiders in your hair. But I bet your daddy scared them all away, huh?
I'm, not her dad. Name's Lee.
I'm Kenny.
Dad, we're in the middle of a fence. There's a tractor and everything.
We better get going, or we won't hear the end of it. That's my boy, Ken Jr. We call him Doc, though.
Doc?
Yeah, nothing bothers him. Like water off a duck's back, you know?
That's a valuable trait lately.
No kidding. But frankly, I think it's because he's dumb as a bag of hammers.
Dad!
But he makes up for it with enthusiasm. The word is, you were on your way to Macon.
My family's from there.
Well, Macon's on the way, and personally, I'd appreciate the company of a guy who can knock a couple of heads together if he has to.
I'll see what the girl would like.
Ah, gotta consult the missus. I understand. Honey, Duck, this is Lee. And, what's the girl's name?
Clementine.
Clementine.
That is a very pretty name.
Thanks.
Well, we should get to work. We've all seen what those things can do out there, so the faster we get this fence up, the better.
I want to build a fence.
Yeah? Well, I need a good foreman. You can sit on the tractor and yell at me whenever I take a water break.
On the tractor? Cool!
Duck and I will hop to it.
I can keep an eye on your little girl here on the porch. We can visit.
All right. So we met Kenny, Kotch and Duck.
It's not the most reliable pickup in the world, but it gets the job done.
Hey there, Kenny. How's your son doing?
Good, I think. Kachi's got a sister up in Memphis. We were coming back from visiting her. We were in a gas station and some guy grabbed my boy. I thought he was kidnapping him. I was on the fucker in about 2 seconds and... Christ. Just lucky I was there. We saw a lot of bodies before we stumbled upon Herschel's, but... we're a tough family, Lee. Ain't nothing gonna faze us.
That's good.
So what's your family's plan?
Get back on down to Lauderdale and let this mess get sorted out. Government will start handing out shots and the National Guard will do its thing. On the odd chance things got too bad, we could hop on my boat, I guess.
You've got a boat?
I'm a commercial fisherman, catching mackerel, dolphin, whatever's biting and paying. Katya wouldn't be wild about it, but the boat's not that bad.
Need any help?
No, I think I got it. Do you need any help?
What do you mean?
I mean in taking care of that little girl. You know what you're doing? You got kids of your own?
Nah. No kids.
Would have liked one then.
You know. See you.
That makes sure how they're doing.
You have said.
You having a nice time with Katya Clementine?
Yeah.
Hey there, girls. You two actually look relaxed.
I think we're doing just fine. Clementine was just telling me about first grade.
Oh, how's that?
It's easy.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you're good?
Anyway, it's almost like we didn't see people eating each other for the past 3 days. It's peaceful here, no?
How did you handle getting through the city?
Kenny just drove. We passed so many people that needed help, and we just passed people over some. Just...
It's okay. It's fine. You don't have to say anymore.
I want to go home tomorrow, but even then I can't take away the things Doc went through. Don't you want to go back to the moment before you knew about all of this?
Anybody in their right mind would. Families and barbecues and beers with good friends.
All of those things.
Those are the things we live for, right? With those gone, what's the point? So, what do you do when corpses aren't walking around?
I'm a veterinarian back in Fort Lauderdale, like Herschel here, except more with dogs and cats and not horses. What is it that you do, Lee?
I used to teach up at the University of Georgia.
We need to hope that we can go back to our jobs soon, Lee. Back to normal. It can't stay like this.
Yeah, my mistake.
We'll all be home soon.
Back in a bit.
Okay, Lee.
All right, let's go, not walk into a well and into tree roots. That's what. All right, so the walking's quite odd, but I'll say I had a duck.
How you doing, Duck?
Good. I'm gonna drive the tractor. I'm the foreman. Lift with your back, Sean.
Right.
Hey, Lee.
Need a hand?
That'd be great. If you could cut those two bys to length, that sure speed things up.
Alright, let's help him cut the 2x4s.
My dad doesn't know how bad it is.
No, he doesn't.
I saw a guy in Atlanta kill a kid. A boy. Just shot him right in the face.
Damn.
No shit, damn. He didn't even hesitate. He just turned, put the barrel of the gun right between the kid's eyes, and pulled the trigger. You don't see things like that. It's not like in the movies.
They don't fall like you think.
Did you have to do it?
Do what?
Kill. Have you had to off one yet?
Oh, I had to shoot one.
I could shoot one, maybe, if it were far away. I'm just glad we're getting this fence built. Dad just wants to keep the family safe and thinks inviting people in is a bigger threat than whatever's out there. How about yours? How's your family?
My brother and parents are in Macon, I hope.
Oh man, I hope so too. Maybe it's not too bad there. That's probably all I need cut for now. Thanks.
And Sean, thanks again for the ride.
No problem, Lee. Couldn't leave you behind. Anyway, when you see my dad around, he might want some help in the barn.
Alright, I'll go around and help. Will let me? No, I guess it won't let me go that way around the house. I'm gonna slowly walk over.
you should know that if you weren't leaving with Kenny today, I wouldn't stand for your lack of honesty last night.
I'm not sure I follow.
How'd you get out of Atlanta?
I was on my way out anyway. Timing of all this just happened to be right.
If there ever is a good time for the supposed apocalypse.
This farm's a nice plot of land.
Had you told me 20 years ago I'd still be doing this, I would have told you that you were full of crap. Never was a plan, having a place like this. It was in the family, and I guess so was I. Family's important. It's all that matters. You agree with that?
Was brought up to, yes.
Where's your family now? Parents? Wife? Girlfriend?
My parents are in Macon, with my brother.
Well, I hope they're all right. But now you've got this little girl to take care of. Clementine, is it? You just stumbled up on her?
I was being attacked and she came to my rescue.
Can I give you a piece of advice?
Sure.
I don't know who you are. Let's say things don't get better back in the cities, or they get worse before they do. You're gonna have to depend on the honesty of strangers if you're gonna make it. And if those same people get to questioning yours, you're gonna be in trouble. So whoever you are and whatever you did, keep it to your damn self. But at least you have the common sense to listen to a man giving you advice.
What the?
Uh-oh.
Go! I'll get my gun!
Shit. I'm sorry, I gotta help save the kid. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry?
Your son is alive.
You don't get to be sorry.
And you didn't even try to help.
I f***ed them both.
You thought wrong. And now...
just go.
Get out and never come back.
Got that ride to Macon if you want it.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to.
This is as far as we're going.
Then it's far enough.
Hey there. You friendly? Truck's run out of gas. Fuck!
Oh, here they are. Okay.
We're trapped! No!
He wasn't fit, I can tell.
Run!
We can't take risks like this. And we can't just let people die, either. When I say that door stays shut no matter what, I fucking mean it. We don't know who these people are. They could be dangerous.
Worse, they could have led them right to us.
Where the hell is your humanity? They would have died out there.
We have kids with us.
I see one little girl.
What is it?
I have to pee.
I'd go out there again in a second.
In a minute, Clem.
They've got kids, Lily.
Those things outside don't care.
Maybe you should go join them then. You'll have something in common. God damn it, Lily. You have to control these people.
Carly and Glenn just ran out there.
I don't give a flying fuck. We're in a war zone.
Lee, can you believe this lady?
That lady's my daughter.
I can see the resemblance. My son will grow up to be a raging tick. That's
one of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't.
We have to end this now.
Over my dead body.
We'll dig one hole.
No, I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten.
Shut up.
We gotta throw him out, or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
Lee, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy. It's...
Lily, I'll handle this.
But your heart, Dad. You need to calm down.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
Everyone, chill the fuck out! Nobody is doing anything.
Shut up, Lily. And you, shut the fuck up. They will find us, and they will get in here. And none of this will fucking matter. But right now, we're about to be trapped in here with one of those things.
What the hell are you talking about?
He's bitten! That's how you turn!
He's not bitten. Lee, stop this. It's upsetting him.
Oh, I'm upsetting him. Upsetting is getting eaten alive.
Dad, we get it. It's a big deal.
Do you? You're not fucking acting like it.
What if this was your daughter?
Never would have happened. She's not some snot-nosed toddler, okay? She's United States Air Force.
Oh, fuck you and her. I'm gonna kill him, Cat. Just worry about Duck.
Lee!
Yeah?
There's someone in there.
It's just locked. Key's behind the counter. Probably.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. I'm just looking out for my daughter.
No, you're just the guy arguing for killing a kid.
He's covered in muck. She'll find the bite. Watch.
She won't.
And if she does, the first thing he'll do is sink his teeth into his mom's face. Then, when she's dead, he'll probably pounce on your little girl. She'll turn fast. And then, there'll be three.
It's a little boy. I think we can handle him.
A little boy? He'll be an uncontrollable man-eater.
It's not gonna happen.
It is. And we're tossing him out now!
You don't touch that boy! You don't touch anybody! I've got a little girl I'm trying to protect in here, too. You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on! You better have a plan to kill me, though, because it's me before anyone else in here!
Jesus!
Clementine! Get away from her, you son of a bitch! Get off!
Hey, come on!
Man,
You okay?
Just great, thanks.
Guys?
Everybody down! Stay quiet!
They're gonna get in! Shut up!
Is that the military?
I don't know.
Thank God for whatever it is.
We almost died because of this bitch and Richie Triggerfinger! That was stupid! That was...
Dad!
What's wrong with him?
It's his heart.
My pills.
Nitroglycerin pills?
Yes, we're out. We've been trying to get into the pharmacy since we got here. Please try to get in there. Behind the counter where the pills are.
We'll get in there somehow.
Thank you so much. We need nitroglycerin pills. Please get in there. I'll keep an eye on my dad.
Everyone else should get comfy and look for anything useful. We could be in here a while.
I'm starting to think this drugstore isn't a permanent solution.
You're right. This ain't exactly Fort Knox.
What do you suggest?
We need as much gas as possible so we can all get out of downtown Macon. Fast.
Agreed.
And I'll head out and get gas. There's a motel not too far from here, out towards the end of Peachtree. I'll work my way towards it and then loop back, siphoning what I can.
You know your way around? Local?
Born and raised.
If you're gonna do that, here's a walkie-talkie if you get in a tight spot. Hopefully, you won't need it.
Cool.
Clementine's got the other one. Check in with her and get back here as soon as you can.
And you, what's your name?
It's Lily. My dad's Larry.
Keep a good eye on him. These boys will work on getting you your medicine.
That's right.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly. You'll shift in with Doug when he needs it. For now, get some rest. You're a good shot, and I'd like to keep it that way.
You got it, boss.
Now get him those pills.
Looks like nobody got a chance to donate anything before this all went down. Central High Tech State. Paper's a week old. Feels like years. You're a pretty good shot.
Well, you don't fuck with a reporter, especially one that's 3 days out from her last cup of coffee.
You seem to handle yourself pretty well.
Really? I'm a disaster.
I can't tell.
My news editor was eaten about 5 feet away from me, and I would have joined her if it wasn't for that dorky guy on watch over there.
I'm sorry.
She was an asshole, but, you know...
Yeah. That guy saved you?
Yeah. Can you believe it? Those creeps or ghouls or whatever the hell they are. They were...
The ones are gonna be, I suppose.
He's kind of cute. In that parents' basement sort of way.
Huh?
Oh, nothing.
How'd you end up here?
We drove up to cover the Cherry Blossom Festival. Real hard-hitting stuff.
Sounds worth it. What are you messing around with there?
A radio. I can't get it to work, though.
Here, let me have a look.
Alright, let's see. Let's see the back. Antenna... battery door. No batteries.
There's no batteries in this thing.
What now?
You know that there are no batteries in that thing.
Yeah, of course. I mean, yeah.
No. I can try to find some. Needs two.
Thanks. I wouldn't even really know what to look for.
All right.
Heard or seen anything?
Nothing, luckily. Wanna step outside, have a look around?
I'm not suicidal yet.
No, the gate out there is closed. We can hang out in front of the store and be fine.
In a little bit.
Not right now.
All right, let me know if you want to.
Look around.
No, sure. I'm sorry to hear your loved one was eaten by the living dead guards.
Ooh, a battery. One battery.
We can't let anything happen to Ducky.
I know, hon.
I don't remember them very well.
Hey, Lee. Really gave that old man hell.
Yeah. We got pushed, you know?
You don't have to tell me. I was ready to tear the man's head off. Anyway, we, Kat and I, appreciate your support.
Thank you, Lee.
Are you guys all right?
We're just fine, considering.
How about you, Duck?
We've all been through a lot.
How's Duck doing?
He's okay. It was just a shock.
We're lucky as hell nobody got nabbed on the way in here.
No kidding.
How's she doing?
She's good, I think.
She's a tough one right there.
She's just a little girl, Ken.
Were you saying, Lee, she spent days surviving on her own?
That's right.
Not just any little girl can do that.
What's the plan?
Hang tight, I suppose. Seems pretty dangerous out there, so we ought to wait for things to clear up.
You said your family was from here in Macon?
That's right.
Where are they? Should we go looking for them?
They, own this place. They're gone.
Oh, sweetie.
Kat.
They were good people. I wasn't around much, but yeah, they're dead.
Lee, you got a second?
Sure.
Back on Herschel's farm.
Yeah.
We didn't even try to save him. That blood is on our hands, you know?
It happened pretty fast.
I guess. But I can't stop seeing him in my head.
We can't kill ourselves.
We killed that boy. We could have saved him together.
We did what we could. Bad things happen. We didn't make a choice that killed Sean. You think you do when you look back on it, but in a moment, when things are really out of control, you don't have any choice.
I guess.
Wise words.
Try to let it go.
Gonna take the candy bar, well, energy bar. And I think I'm gonna give it to Clem.
We just need to get back to Fort Lauderdale.
We'll do our damnedest.
Let's see, another energy bar. I think I'll give that one to Duck. Because I don't think he needs an energy bar. Well, she might, but. Hey, Clem. No. Ooh, battery. Can get the radio working. I'll do that. Probably, yeah, there's definitely no money in that ATM. I'll go into the office soon as well.
Try to get some rest, hon.
How can I with those things out there?
This battery should fit the radio.
Great, thanks.
And here's another one.
Should be able to get it to work now.
It's still not working?
Yeah, I can't figure it out.
Let me have a look at that thing.
Go ahead.
Nothing.
how they end the wrong way. Yep.
You fixed it.
Continues to spread unchecked. The estimated death toll continues to skyrocket. WABE urges you to stay indoors and avoid any contact with individuals you suspect may have been exposed.
The station is okay.
In the event of a full... my producer's telling me we have to get off the air now.
Steve.
WABE wishes you and your loved ones... God bless you all.
Ugh, doesn't sound too good.
It's not damaged. Glad this place didn't get looted.
Let's talk to Clementine first, and then we'll...
Hey there.
Hi.
Can I, get you anything?
I'm okay. Maybe I'm a little hungry.
Any word from Glenn?
Nothing. Is he okay?
Yeah, I think so. You're doing a good job. So,
are you okay?
What? I'm fine. I just, I'm good.
That's good.
Yeah, I think so. Being good is good, despite the circumstances.
Yep.
We'll sit tight.
Okay.
And, I'm gonna give Clementine...
But here you go.
Then you back.
Thank you.
Of course.
And, gonna give it to, alright, I went the wrong way. You guys.
It's not much, but here. For the boy.
Oh, thanks, Lee. He appreciates it.
That's sweet, Lee.
Alright, now let's go in the office. And then I'll go out with Doug. Oh my god, I keep going the wrong way.
The pills are in there.
I don't think there's any more alive inside.
What's that?
This is my dad's cane. He'd zip around here on it from time to time.
Was he sick?
Nah, he was okay. I actually saw him whoop shoplifters with it. This cane's protected this place better than any guard dog ever could. Plus, he knew how to make it look cool. Like you with your hat.
My dad gave it to me.
See, dads are smart like that.
I'm gonna look at the first aid kit.
Luckily, there's nothing I need in here.
Find anything?
It's a photo of the family who owned this place. Might help us track down the keys to the office.
I know who you are. You're Lee Everett. You're a professor at Athens who killed a state senator who was sleeping with your wife. This is your parents' store. Folks around town know the owner's son got himself a life sentence, but I'm a reporter for WABE in Atlanta. I paid attention to that trial. Maybe you're a murderer, but I don't really care. Frankly, that's a skill that might come in handy. Did you tell anyone out there who you were, or that you were tied to this place?
No. I've been sticking to first names for a reason.
You seem like an okay guy, and the last thing we need is drama out there. You've got this little girl to take care of, and look, don't make me wrong on this.
I don't plan to.
Good, because if this lasts longer than a few days, and you're a detriment to the group, then we'd have a problem.
I hear you.
I'll just keep it to myself.
Thanks.
Don't worry about it.
My parents came in here hoping to survive. But it looks like one of them was hurt. I wonder if it was my dad. Trying to be a hero, maybe. Or a protector, at least. We gotta clear this door for when we find the keys. Better get this door clear, huh?
Can I help?
Sure. Here we go. Watch your fingers in the drawers. How are you doing?
Yeah, it's not that heavy.
How about with everything outside?
It's not good.
No, it's not.
But I think it'll be okay.
Okay, here we go.
Do you have kids?
No.
You don't have a family?
What do your parents do?
My mom is a doctor, and my dad is an engineer.
Those are good jobs.
What's your job?
I teach history and writing and things like that.
Like social studies?
Yeah, like that.
You didn't answer my question.
All right, a little further.
Why don't you want to talk about your family? Do they, like, hate you?
Because they're dead.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You didn't know.
I'm just sorry for being mean.
Yeah. My family's gone, and I just wish things would have been different.
Yeah.
I'm not a bad guy, okay? Things happen, and we didn't talk much after that.
My parents don't talk to me when I get in trouble.
I can relate.
Ow!
Oh no, Clementine.
I hurt my finger.
Is it bleeding?
A little.
I'll find you a bandage.
Nothing in there. Where is it?
Let's have a look at that finger.
Ow. It hurt.
Let's see if we can do something about it. Let's get this cut covered up.
Yes, please.
All right. There you go.
Lee?
Yeah?
What if my parents come home and I'm not there?
They'll track us down. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay. We should keep a lookout. I've got my walkie-talkie in case they try that way.
Stay close to me until then, okay? It's locked. We need to track down the keys if we're gonna help Larry. How's your finger?
It's okay. Thanks for fixing it.
Everyone out there seem all right to you?
Yeah. Well, maybe not the sick guy.
Yeah. We'll keep an eye on him.
And there was that thing in the bathroom. It tried to get me.
I know.
But you stopped it.
Yeah, I did.
Can you do that more?
Well, I'm not gonna go looking for him.
I mean, get the dangerous ones.
I'm gonna try.
Good.
Have you heard from Glenn?
Not in a little while.
I'm gonna keep looking around.
Okay.
Alright. Let's,
Wanna head back into the drugstore with me?
Okay. Lee?
Let's...
Yeah?
You're not bad, right?
Why are you asking me that?
That lady said you killed someone. Was that because he was one of the things trying to eat you?
It's complicated. Sometimes things happen, or you do things and you can't explain them. Let's, head back to the others.
Alright, let's
How we doing?
See if we can go outside.
Wanna go have a look around outside?
Yeah, I'll look around this time.
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Okay. Nonchalant about looking around outside.
Jesus.
Just standing here. Oh, God.
Just
eat. As far as I can tell, that's all they care about.
And if one gets you,
they eat you. And whatever's left comes back as one of them.
How the fuck?
I think it might be more than a couple days before all this gets sorted out.
Yeah, I think so too. We better keep it down out of here. Man, that's a hasty fortification job over there.
Yeah, it didn't work.
I guess not.
Too bad we don't have a way to come out here and watch the news.
Would be nice to know what's going on elsewhere.
Atlanta's in rough shape, that's all I know. Did you guys try to get in there and get weapons?
I did, but it was too risky. And then a bunch of guys showed up and they tried.
And what happened?
I think they're most of who you see wandering around out there.
Look at the one trapped over there.
Better him than us, huh?
Oh, shit.
What? Do you know that guy?
He could be a drugstore employee.
So you're saying he might have the pharmacy keys?
I'm saying he might have the pharmacy keys.
I don't know. Could be anybody, you know? They start rotting and get all chewed up and...
Shut up, Doc. Look at the uniform, though. He could have worked at the drugstore and died with keys in his pocket.
It would take a lot of effort to make it safe enough to go out there and see if he has the keys. If we could somehow prove that he worked here, I think it'd be worth it.
I'll see what I can find. That guy over there has the keys.
How can you be sure?
I found this in the office. That boy in the photo worked here. The keys being on him is as good a bet as we can make.
Yeah, I agree. Just need to figure out how to get out there and get them. You wouldn't need long, right?
Nah, just a few seconds.
Maybe there's a way to distract them and buy you some time.
I can't reach that brick.
Can't reach the brick.
Doc, you want to get this door open?
About that.
You've got the combo, right?
No.
Did anyone ever have it?
Look, man, there were a lot of those things trying to get in here.
And now we can't get back out onto the street.
We're also party to some egregious fire code violations.
Need that brick and to throw it there.
We should think about searching that guy across the street.
Maybe he has them, but who knows if he actually worked here.
Well, we already know, but...
How'd you end up here?
I moved here to live with my uncle. He does tech stuff, and it just made sense.
So you're local. You probably knew the owners of this place.
No, not really. I've only been here a couple months, and I spend a lot of time...
On the computer?
No, just doing my own thing. What about you?
I grew up here. Been trying to get home since the day I came back.
Oh. So, you probably knew the owners then?
Yeah, I did. Good people.
Let's head back inside and...
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
So, we need to get a way to be able to throw the brick across.
Hey there. This is Glenn, and, I'm kinda in a jam here. Little girl, if you're there, can you put your daddy on the phone? Or on the talkie, or whatever?
This is Lee. What's up?
So, I'm down at that motor inn, and, well, I'm stuck.
Stuck?
Yeah, I saw a chance to get some supplies for the group, and a bunch of the Roman ones got the jump on me. I'm hiding over here, but they won't leave.
What's up?
Glenn's trapped down at the motor inn. Hey, Glenn. We're gonna talk it over and send a group to come get you, all right?
Awesome. I'll sit tight till then.
Sounds good. I'm gonna hold on to this until we get Glenn back, okay? I'll take good care of it.
What do you think?
I think Doug's not great around zombies. You got your family here. I'll take Carly and her dead eye down to the motor inn, get Glenn, and get back here as fast as I can.
If that's what you want to do...
Somebody's got to.
Yeah, I'm in.
Good. Doesn't sound too bad there right now.
Let me know as soon as you want to head out. I could use a jog.
Yeah, I think we're supposed to do that first. Oh, there's another energy bar. Sweet. Who should I give this one to? Carly? Yeah, it'd be good to give her some energy before we head out.
Here, I've been finding some stuff to eat.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Are you sure your girl doesn't need it?
She's good. I've been trying to keep her fed and watered.
You're a good caretaker.
Thanks.
Alright.
Hey, Carly.
Yeah, let's head out.
That radio sign-off didn't sound too good. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You don't have to be. It's traumatic.
I'm sure some people got out. Maybe they're all being rescued. Then again, maybe not.
Let's head out.
Hey there. You ready to head out?
You got it. You?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Shit. Get down!
Did you see that?
I sure did. Be ready to shoot.
Guys! Oh, man. I'm glad you're here.
Jesus, Glenn.
Right then wasn't so hard.
Can we get out of here before any of these things notice us?
Not yet. There's a survivor trapped up there.
No way. We gotta go. Now!
Listen, I was out here looking for gas, and then up there in the corner room, I heard crying coming from inside.
Who is it?
It's a girl. We talked and she got frightened. I was trying to get in and help her and she started yelling and saying I was bitten. I tried to convince her I wasn't, and that's when all these guys came out of the forest. A couple almost got me, and I ended up hiding in the ice machine.
Lucky you. Now let's go.
We can't just leave her.
Damn right we can.
You guys are suicidal. Over a girl.
I'm saving her, with or without you.
Think about if it was you.
Fine. Let's go save Glenn's damsel in distress.
Some zombies up there. One down there by the axe. That fire axe could come in handy when there. You might want to watch out for him. He could be a trouble one. One having a feast over there.
This is the plan. We don't know how hard it's going to be to get her out of that room.
Yeah, it's boarded up.
So we have to kill every one of them in here. Quietly. Noise attracts these things. Now let's have a look around.
Oh, man. She's eating something. So we got that one right there, close.
We can hide by that RV if we're quiet and keep our heads down.
Alright. I'm gonna try running to that RV.
There's one back there, trying to get into a room, but I didn't see anyone actually in there.
I'm not sure I can take them both out myself, even if I had a weapon.
Head back to the brick wall. Let's do this stealthily. What's over here?
They really want to get into that room. They really want to get into that room.
Just keep saying the same thing. Alright, let's see what we have here.
I wonder if there's anything in the pickup.
We don't want to smash the...
We can do something with that car, I bet. If it weren't for that fella lurking near the front.
And what happens if we...
Ow!
Hey man, that drew some attention. Be careful.
Alright, What do we do? Let's run back to the brick wall and oh, there's a pillow.
Good luck smothering them to death.
That's not really what I have in mind.
Oh, we can do the shoot through pillow technique. Right, I already,
What What are you gonna do with that?
I don't really know. Do you have any tricks for getting into cars?
Not without tools, or making a bunch of noise, and none with pillows.
Alright, so... Oh, wait, hold on. The pillow's not for that. Pillow's for killing one of the guys over there, I think? Right? Hold on. Nope. Run over here. Slowly but and quietly. Well, quickly and quietly. And over here you can
get one pillow and two corpses.
An age old problem.
Well, I got one pillow and two corpses.
An age old problem.
Okay. I guess not. Hold on. What are we supposed to... Oh, maybe... Hold on. Do we kill him with the pillow? Maybe?
Get out your gun.
But the noise...
Just follow my lead. Stay right behind me.
That was sick!
Alright. Let's try opening the door. Sparks. That can be useful. Unlock the gear shift.
It's a sparky thing.
Spark plug. You should hold on to that. Could come in handy.
And let's push the car.
That was awesome!
Yeah, let's use a spark plug on this.
Wait. Let me see the spark plug. The porcelain inside these things turns car windows to tissue paper.
Well, that picture on the right, that kind of looks... Alright, yeah, that... My dirty mind. Take the awl.
That could scramble a brain pretty good.
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Oh, that also goes there? Okay. Let's head back to here and get those guys on the other side of the RV. Oh, yeah, all this one. Nice. Noise, noise, noise. That's what you get, bitch. Get awed. Oh, you poor help this thing. Oh, dead. Yeah, that's all the way in there.
Dude, where'd your weapon go?
Into that ice pick sized hole.
Holy shit. It's cool. Now we've got this.
Are you two done?
Two more.
That should help.
Yep.
don't you guys lag behind just in case this goes to hell?
Okay, we'll be right behind you.
Creeping, we're creeping, we're creeping. Whoa.
Hello in there. We're here to help.
Please just go away.
Let's go, guys.
In a minute. If you open up, we can take you somewhere safer. We've got a group in town.
No. Please.
She's in trouble.
No. Miss, we're coming in.
I don't want to...
coming out.
You're hurt.
Oh, God.
I said stay away.
We need to get you help.
It's too late for that.
Guys, she's been bitten.
What?
I told you, I said go away. I'm bit. But you wouldn't just leave.
Let's calm down. You could be fine.
I won't be fine. My boyfriend was bitten. You get sick and you die and you come back and you kill anything you can find.
You have a boyfriend?
Glenn.
I don't want that. It's not Christian. Please, just leave me. Please go.
Okay, we'll leave. Just try to take care of yourself for whatever time you have left.
You have a gun.
So?
Can I borrow it?
What do you mean, borrow?
Give it to me. I can just, you know, end this, and then there's no problem.
Whoa.
Please, I don't want to be one of them. They're satanic.
We can't let you do that to yourself.
Then do it for me.
We need to get going.
Give it to me, please.
This is crazy.
Please, step back.
It's just 2 seconds, just one bullet. And I can be with my family, and it'll all be fine.
Miss.
Back up. Please!
Whoa!
Whoa, take it easy. We just want to help.
You can't.
Miss, just relax now. You need to think this through. We'll find you a doctor. It'll be okay. Let's all just...
No!
Let's get out of here.
Damn.
Shit!
Here they come!
Go, get out.
Get in!
Everyone all right?
Yeah, we had some close calls, but Glenn is fine and... Well, yeah. We're okay.
I've got a few cans of gas for pick up in the trunk of my car.
Good to hear it.
And things back here?
Quiet. Our friend is still in and out over there. He won't survive any more stress.
The next order of business is getting those pills out of the pharmacy. How are we doing?
If you don't mind, I think my family and I are gonna rest for a bit. Let me know if that asshole over there takes a turn for the worse.
You got it.
Hey, let's talk to Clem. wherever she is. Come on, over here.
How's your finger, Clem?
Good. It doesn't hurt so much anymore.
Good.
I gave you a treat already. You ready?
I know I'm not your
dad, but if you need
anything, I'm your guy, okay?
Okay, same.
You're my guy?
Oh, no. You know.
We're gonna try to take care of each other.
Yes, deal.
Let me know if you need anything.
Okay.
I just got that part out.
How you doing, Glenn?
You know.
Do you know the combination for the lock on the gate outside?
Why?
Oh, you know. I thought I'd go stretch my legs.
You're probably better off breaking it if you have to.
Back the motor in.
How can it be that bad so fast?
You know, when things are taken away, people do crazy shit.
I guess. But that's not me. I'm not giving up. Not for anything.
Good, man. Good.
I guess you really wanted that gun.
Seems like.
Why didn't you tell Carly to just give it to her?
People can't be given up. This will pass.
I'm with you.
I'm glad to hear it. What's your next move?
I don't know. I mean, you guys seem okay.
What about your family?
Yeah, I...
Forget it, man. That's your business.
I hate feeling like I can't do anything.
I know the feeling, man. Try to get some rest.
Huh. Yeah, right.
Talk to Carly and then I'll head out.
Story of the century here, huh?
Yeah, and I've got shit for recording equipment. And from the looks of it, there isn't going to be any shortage of first-hand accounts.
You do radio?
That's right. Well, until some piece of shit politicians yank our funding, and I hit the blogosphere.
I better get back to it.
Yep.
Thanks, by the way.
Don't mention it. Just remember what I said.
Yeah, I will. How we doing?
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Yeah,
let's have a look around.
Okay.
Okay. I think we should break the lock.
Awesome. Now to distract those things. Carefully.
All right. Hit the brick.
The brick.
Alright, wow, to open that a little bit. And now, throw it at the TV store.
Vandalism. Nice.
I got an idea. That place is full of TVs and electronics.
What's my idea?
Let's head back inside.
Okay.
Alright, they just left it wide open, yep. Smart. Like, not really, but... do we have a remote? Maybe? What's my idea?
Can I do anything for you, Carly?
I'm fine, thanks.
Alright, I guess nothing.
You alright, Lee?
I'm okay. Thanks.
Alright. Clem?
Everything okay?
Mm-hmm.
How's he doing?
I'm not sure I got your name.
It's Lee.
Lily. My dad's Larry. I was just doing what I had to earlier.
Everyone was.
Now his heart's acting up again and I'm powerless to do anything. And that violence before with my dad, that didn't help.
What do you think about all this?
What is there to think? The dead are up, walking around, eating people, and turning them into more of them. I mean, Jesus.
We need to stick together and get through this. What's wrong with him?
He's got a heart condition. He takes nitroglycerin tablets pretty regularly. I've seen a few bad attacks that he couldn't get over and needed to go to the hospital.
Yeah, that's not really an option right now.
I'm just trying to keep him relaxed.
You're from here?
I work at Warner Robins, the Air Force base.
Yeah, I know it. Pilot?
Nah, just mechanical admin stuff. I deal with a bunch of shitheads and bureaucrats all day. Sometimes a plane, if I'm lucky. You?
I work up at UGA. Was anyone here when you guys got here?
No, this place was pretty wrecked. We pulled a couple of bodies out of the office. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Did you know anybody here?
Yeah, the owners, they were, we were close.
I'm sorry. We found an older couple in the office. Dad hauled them out in case they weren't really dead. I'm gonna get back to him.
I'm not gonna say it. I don't want to say he's got a temper. That'd be... Is there a remote in here? Was there? I must be either stupid, blind... Oh, right. Wasn't there one in the drawer, right?
It's the remote to my dad's TV.
And it'll work for those ones. Can I turn on that TV?
That's what I figured.
Alright, I guess I can't walk around a bucket, you know. Alright, let's use the TV on the TVs out there. It was this way, right? Nope, I meant the wrong way. It's right over here. That's kind of, ow, I just bit my tongue.
Want to go have a look around outside?
Yeah.
Not now.
Nope, right. I pressed the wrong button. I'm an idiot.
Good. Want to go have a look around outside?
Let's have a look around.
Okay.
Alright.
Think you can do anything with this?
You know what I could do?
What's that?
It's universal. I could program it to work with those TVs across the street. Let's just hope the power is still on.
You can just do that?
Well, I memorized all the codes when I was in AV. Let's try.
Well fucking done, Doug. All that dork nonsense might save a life.
Who's to say it already hasn't?
Alright, now they're gonna go over to the TVs. Alright.
Now's the time.
Be careful.
Keep an eye out, will you? Hey, what happened to Mom and Dad, but I know if you were there, you would have died for them. So, yeah. I'm gonna assume that's what happened.
Did you find them yet?
Give me a second. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I wasn't here. But knowing you were to take care of them through all of it, that helped.
Oh, I didn't cut all the way through.
Fuck!
Damn, this makes it so much worse. Oh my god. Why didn't you just go for the... Alright. Take your time trying to get through the brain. Yep. You know.
God. There we go.
Holy crap! Run!
Go. All right.
Man, that was close.
But we did it. It's all that matters. I've got the keys.
Great. God, you're amazing. Let's get in there. Gotta hurry.
That's not, no, that's not the girl that killed herself. I don't think. I mean, the girl that killed herself shot herself, so... And she didn't have it all in the back of her shoulder.
Doc, come on, baby, time to go.
I'm gonna get the truck pulled up round back!
Do it fast! I gotta get my dad out of here!
I don't plan on dilly-dallying! Honey, take Duck into the office and barricade the living hell out of the door behind me. Glenn, when you hear me honking in the alley, start getting people out of here.
You got it.
Doug, Carly, and Lee, you guys make sure our defenses stay up till then. And Lee, I better take that axe in case I run into any of them on the way to my truck.
Here you go.
All right, that door's not locked anymore.
Shit. You three, get on it. I'll get back as fast as I can.
Stay away from the windows.
Glenn, we need your...
Hey, Lee, if we don't make it through this, you should know that I think you're a great guy.
We will make it through this!
Doug, if we don't make it through this, you should know!
I should know what?
Huh?
You said I should know...
Shit! On it.
Are you sure?
Oh, shit!
What? Oh, shit! Okay, then. Clementine! Can you look for something to stick in between the handles? Something real strong, okay?
Okay.
Clementine, did you find anything?
Nothing! Wait!
That window is screwed!
Go!
Come on! X!
I found something!
There we go.
No! Get off, get off!
Oh no!
Get off me! Get off me! Get them off me!
I have to save Curly. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. No.
Oh my God.
Let's go!
They got Doug. They...
You gotta move! You're not covered with this, you son of a bitch! Letting somebody else get eaten today, especially a good friend.
Thanks, Kenny. I knew I could count on you. That was when they killed herself.
Hey, Glenn.
I think I need to go.
To Atlanta?
Yeah. I got friends there. And I just can't stay here knowing that they could be trapped in that city.
Sounds like nobody knows what's happening there. When we left a few days ago, could have gone either way.
I gotta take my chances.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
And I gotta do this.
I respect that.
You guys be safe.
We'll try.
Shit happens. The most real bumper sticker ever.
Hey, Ken.
Close call back there.
Thanks for picking me up.
No problem. We have to take care of each other.
Yeah, we do.
Hey, about Clementine.
Yeah?
Earlier I said there's some stuff out there that might screw up a precious little girl like her.
You did.
Well, I still think that's true. But after what I saw today, I think between you taking care of her and her taking care of herself, you two are gonna be just fine.
Thanks, Kenny.
You got it.
How you doing, Carly?
I'm okay. You know, considering.
I do, yeah.
I can't stop thinking about Doug. We couldn't have saved him, could we?
I don't think so. It happened pretty fast.
I know it's stupid. We just met. And he was such a... It's just that... I think that I liked him. Everything we
I'm sorry, Carr.
It's okay. Thanks, though. There's been a lot of death in the past few days. Anyway, I'd rather be alone, I think.
I understand.
Wait, Lee?
What is it?
How did you choose? We both needed you. You picked me. Did you check the glove box?
I swear I saw it. I was gonna help you both.
But you helped me first.
Yeah, I did.
I just wish we both could have made it, you know?
Me too, Carly.
Is there a way for... I don't know.
The Dinatron has this minigun on his shoulder. It's all like pow, pow, pow. I thought Super Dinosaur was toast. But you know what? He wasn't. Oh, and then...
Hey, Duck, you want to cool it for a minute?
Okay, sorry.
I'm sorry, there's not a lot of kids here.
No, it's not that. It's... I got grabbed again.
I was there, though.
I fell, and my walkie-talkie broke. Glenn had the other one.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks. I know I need to be tough. I'm just sad. I know it doesn't make any sense, but it's how I used to talk to my mom and dad. And now they're gone. It's gone.
Maybe we can find you another one.
I'll just keep this one, I guess.
Lee, come here for a second.
Let me go deal with this.
Oh, man, Clementine, another thing.
What do you want?
You like my daughter?
Yeah, she's great.
Well, stay the fuck away from her.
Or what?
Or, everyone will know that you, Lee Everett, are a killer. And you were before it was something you had to do to stay alive. I know who you are. And I don't give a shit about what happens to you. But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you, you watch your ass.
Hey, Lee, do you have a second? My dad would be dead if it weren't for you.
That guy Doug is dead because of me.
You can't be like that. You're only one man.
I don't know.
We're lucky to have you.
I hope that's the sound of us winning this thing.
Me too.
This motor inn's pretty damn defendable. We block off the entrances with some cars, keep someone on watch. We could stay here until the military rolls through.
I actually agree with that plan.
Me too.
We got beds, we got water, and most importantly, we got light. There are worse places to call home.
Yeah, you're right. You know, guys, I think it's going to be okay.
Oh, all right. That was episode one. Nope, next time.
I thought we'd be fine if we survived the walkers. Never expected they'd starve us out.
I want you to have this, okay? In case you or Clementine starts feeling weak.
You don't owe me anything, Carly. How you doing, Clementine?
I'm really hungry, Lee.
We gotta get food, Lee. Soon.
Howdy. I'm Andrew St. John. We're from the St. John Dairy.
It's beautiful.
I never did thank you for saving Duck from the walkers back at Herschel's farm.
Something's coming, Lee. There's gonna be a war.
The walkers don't worry me as much as the bandits.
You fucked with us! Now we're gonna take what we want!
There's too many of them!
You never liked my dad. Even back at the drugstore when everyone thought Kenny's kid was bit, you went out of your way to side against him!
This isn't happening!
Please. Yeesh. Alright, so that's what's happening next time. What did I don't know when I died, when I lied. Lied with Kenny. Gave Irene the gun. I didn't. Damn. Yeah. Bad choices. I know my choices suck. I know. But. Oh. Alright, well. That's been episode 1 of The Walking Dead season 1. I hope you guys enjoyed. I will be doing episode 2 next time. That should be up, I don't know when, but whenever I record it. We'll see. But I hope you guys enjoyed. And stay tuned, because at the end of me doing season 1, season 2, and Michonne, I will be doing season 3 as well. I just felt like doing all the games, because I don't have any of them on my channel, so might as well do all of them. So thank you guys all for watching. I hope you guys had a great time, and I'll see you next time. If you liked, please leave a like button. If you hate my choices, leave a dislike, or let me know what you would have chose differently with the choices down in the comments. Thank you guys, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye, everybody.